we deciding? Please welcome Toastmaster Vijayalakshmi. Should I be buying this house or renting this house? How should I go to office? By bus or in my car? Should that subordinate be promoted or sacked? Where do I invest my retirement proceeds? Which insurance policy do I take? Oh God, the questions and decisions are endless. Dear Toastmaster, fellow members and guests, good evening.
Good evening.
Every day, we take so many decisions. The smart decision skills help us to grow and also have a peaceful life. Let us for a minute analyze if our decisions are rational. Bad decisions can damage our life and also it can make us struggle the lifetime. Friends, why do we take bad decisions? We are caught into certain routines in our mind and we tend to use the same when we make our decision rather than logically analyzing anything. So bad decisions impact our life. There are many hidden traps to our decision making. Let us recognize few of these traps which force us to take bad decisions. The first trap which is forcing us the thought is the anchoring trap. We pay undue advantage or weightage to the first information we receive and all the time guided by that. The anchors very well know this. They try to force fit their first thought process on us. They get the expected decision from us because they have force fitted their thought. If you go to a restaurant, there will be a menu card which is given to us. It will look like one research paper. And I many times wonder how this restaurant is able to manage so many choices to the customer when they find it difficult to just make two or one item in my house. But in the menu card, you will see there are certain items highlighted as the chef's choice or the customer's choice. So by highlighting those items, the restaurant is force-fitting their decision on us. We invariably tend to select those items. And if we also look around as to what the other customers are having, they will also be having one of the highlighted items. And there are some customers who go one step forward. They ask the steward, "Sir, can you please suggest something what our family can have?" What do I say? Yeah. These people are not even caught in the anchoring trap. They have just fallen into the anchoring pit. The next trap, which is sitting on our head, is the sunk cost. Sunk cost is a case where we try to defend a cost based on our past mistakes. There are people who keep buying second-hand cars. Their original decision could have been flawed, but they keep servicing the vehicle, justifying the original decision. What I am saying is, why can't they just reconcile to the fact that their original decision was an error? Sell the vehicle for the price, whatever it fetches, and move on in the life. That will help them to come out of this sunk cost. The third one, which is troubling us, is the status quo effect. What is status quo effect? We get a lot of comfort about this current situation where we are in. When I applied for a housing loan, I looked at many options. I pleaded, convinced, and somehow got the best deal from the bank. I felt very happy getting the best deal from the bank. Within 2 years from the time I got this settled, the same bank came out with another advertisement and the offer was much better than what was given to me. It had a single line in that advertisement which said, "This is applicable only for new customers or new loans." Ideally, I should have gone to the bank, renegotiated my deal, or switched my loan to another bank. But the status quo comfort dissuaded me from doing that. There are many organizations who offer new schemes, but we are not actually aware of that, and we are feeling very comfortable with where we are. If we do not recognize this status quo issue, we will turn out like our current government, struggling with making the decision and not able to roll out any key changes. Friends, the final trap which is dangerous is the framing trap. So what it means is, it is the way the options have been given to us and we do not know the intention behind it. So, to quote an example, a newspaper company quoted its rates. It said, it is, if you want to read the newspaper in mobile per month, it is 80 rupees. If you want to read it in the personal computer, it is 100 rupees. If you want to read it in the mobile and also personal computer, it is 110 rupees. Majority of the customers chose the last option. Friends, they may not even have a computer at home to read the newspaper. That is immaterial. Because of the framing trap, they got caught into the last option. So, to come over these traps, we should first know that people try to anchor their views. We might get caught into the framing trap. Friends, do we look at the sources based on which we have finalized a decision? Are those sources tested and trusted? When we consciously look into that, in that train incident, I was able to, where I was coming from Chennai to Bangalore, there was a guy who was trying to give the pamphlets to everybody, keeping a 50 rupee note on the top. And because that 50 rupee note was given, everybody tried to as a gift of 50 rupees. But I was able to sit tight, not touch my wallet, and give a vague look to the customers. So such thought process about these traps helps us to come over it. And what I am trying to tell is, if we analyze our decisions for these traps, then we will be able to break these traps, take radical decisions, and lead a better life. Our life or decision should be an action of conscious thinking, not a reaction to the laid down traps. Over to you, Toastmaster.